This is Armin Sanger.
This is Oscar White.
Have you ever thought about your perfect day?
What would you be doing? Who would you be doing it with? Where would you be?
We're here now with Zoom to find out with a very special guest.
A very
We're
special guest.
excited. We're excited. Finn Baxter. I used to cozy down in the front row with him back in the day. He made it out into the professional arena as a rugby player, playing for Harlequins, going great. Finn, how are you doing?
Yeah, really well, thank you. It's nice to be here. How are you,
Well,
sir?
we're excited.
We're good, we're
We're
good.
excited. It's a change up. We're using Zoom, but we're able to get different type of guests now. We're able to get out of Durham, the small Durham. Before we get on the
Small
perfect
though.
day, me and Oscar thought the listeners would be, itching to hear what's the normal day like for a professional rugby player. Kind of like, let's compare it to your perfect day. See
Yeah,
the ups
it's
and
stark contrast, isn't it?
downs.
I think like a usual start would be like 8 o'clock, 8:30, whether that be like meetings or however obviously the day changes so quickly and every week. But yeah, 8:30 with meetings, gym, and then we'll do some sort of like unit block, like scrums or line outs, lunch. Another meeting, training, and then any extras after that. Usually finishing at like 4. Yeah,
Are you
but
training every day?
so 2 main training days a week, and then the first day of the week is usually like a learning day, getting the knowledge in there, and again weights
What's
then as
that
well
leading
because
up to the match on the weekend?
yeah. So that'd be like the different plans for that weekend.
Okay. Oh, brilliant. And kind of in general, how's the obviously it's been like from leaving school to kind of getting in the professional setup and obviously doing really well in certain games. How's that process been? What have the emotions been like?
Yeah, I mean, it's been a bit weird. Like I has jumped about real quick. So I only made my debut through like through COVID. So like there was a who was it? There was a major injury with Collier, and then Kerrod got COVID, and there was no one left. And so I
You're
got
selling yourself short.
Harmful, aren't you? Exactly, but it's a common theme. Mostly how people start, it's just through luck, and I got my chance. I did pretty little
Nailed
right,
it. Nailed it.
and just kept knocking on the door really, and yeah, it's been pretty good since.
No,
Yeah,
that's brilliant. Let's get into it. I want to hear about Finn
yeah.
Baxter's
So,
perfect day. Have you
yeah.
been hard thinking about it or?
I've thought about it quite a lot, and I've run it past quite a few people as well, and they picked up some major points that I missed out, which I love,
Okay,
that are being included.
let's start off. Where are you waking up on this perfect day?
So, through my whole kind of childhood, we used to go to Salcombe or somewhere in South Devon every year, and I mean, at first I said like it's I'm waking up in Salcombe, but I'm just vaguely South Devon. We're on the coast. And I'm waking up and I'm here in the harbour. I'm hearing boats. I'm hearing the waves. Few seagulls here and there. Can't be like actually no. It's perfect. No seagulls.
What are we? Is it
Yeah.
summer's day?
So it's spring,
Springs,
with about 16 degrees. I'm quite a hot person, so I
yeah.
can't deal with any hotter than that. So
Yeah.
spring, clear sky, and a bit of a breeze is on, and it's yeah, crisp.
What did you used to do in Salcombe? What is that, sailing, going in the
So
sea?
yeah, sailing in the estuary, but just generally just messing about on the beach, which is yeah, to
Yeah,
come.
and I'd be interested to hear your thoughts, for me and Oz debating the whole time. What's your opinion on like cold seawater swimming? Is it good for the muscles? Is it good for the mentals? Find some light there.
I mean, so it's gotta be to be good for like your like physically, it's gotta be pretty cold. It's gotta
Yeah.
be like 5 to 15 degrees, I think, is the range. But for mental health, it's brilliant. I've read a bit about it, and yeah, it's really good for you.
You doing quite a lot of ice baths for recovery?
Yeah, m most most training days at least. It's just that it helps with soreness. Just
yeah. I've been trying to get an ice bath for our flat, but no one's got one of those Lumi ones.
They've been everywhere, haven't they?
Yeah, no one wants to chip in.
And what, so you're kind of on the beach, is there anyone in particular or a group of people that you'd want to be with? Is that
not to start with?
Okay.
Not to start with, because I'd like to wake up. Can you say my breakfast?
Yeah.
I'm walking out of the little place I'm staying. It's not extravagant, just a little modest place. Walking out, literally walking 10 meters down the street, there's a bakery.
Yes.
I'm grabbing a pasty. It doesn't matter that it's 10 a.m. Grab a pasty.
Yeah.
Next door, coffee shop. Grab a flat white and straight on the beach for a little walk. No longer, though, than 20 minutes, because otherwise it's just too long.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That sounds relaxing. Yeah. It sounds like a lovely, tranquil start. What's in the pasty?
Traditional.
Traditional.
Like, no messing about.
No, that sounds brilliant. And what kind of, are you into the beach being packed, or do you want it really quiet so you can just collect your thoughts at the start of the day? And
nice and quiet. and spring weather hopefully is doing something to shoo people away. We're off season. That's off what it is. We're off season.
So you go to Sulcombe with your family? Do you have brothers or sisters or?
Yeah, I've got a younger brother, and we spent hours messing about, and it's key memories.
Yeah. Spike ball on the beach.
Well, spike ball's new, so we never actually had that. But like 1v1 cricket, which sounds mental, but
you're just hitting it, and one person has to go and get it.
Yeah, go get it.
Are you batting? About 5 miles. Yeah. Are you batting and just sending your brother down the coast?
He didn't quite learn, did he? But
yeah.
Okay. So we're starting off in Sulcombe.
Yeah.
Do you want to do the day with one particular person? Do you have a particular person in mind, or how do you want to?
I want a group of eight.
You can bring them on as you go. To be fair.
Okay. So I'd like to start with. So at the end of my walk.
Yeah.
I've sat down. There is a bench on the beach. I sat on the bench. I look down. I look back up. I'm at Craven Cottage.
Whoa! Huge transition.
I'm in the season ticket seat behind the goal, and we're playing Chelsea.
Oh, I like that.
And Harry Kane, my best mate, we are season tickets together, and we watch us win 3-0. That's a great start.
Do you manage with the busy schedule? Do you manage to get to Craven Cottage a lot, or is it something you want to do more?
Yeah, I've got quite lucky. In when we were last year in the Championship, I was going something silly like 5 times a month because of like the and stuff like that. But this year I've managed to get to quite a few. I think I've got something like 8, maybe 9 home games.
Best game so far? Best atmosphere? Best game?
Probably the Chelsea 1-0 win. As much as we shouldn't have won it, it was
the one where Felix got sent off.
Yeah, and he is some player. He was carving. I'm really thank God he got banned. But
who do you normally go to the matches with?
So my mate, who has this other season ticket, but when he's at uni, I just take just mates really.
Harry Kane. Why Harry Kane?
He's just my best. Sorry, he's the name of my best mate. It's
it's not the footballer. You're talking about Harry Kane.
Not the footballer. No, it's not the mum.
I wanted to ask maybe about the World Cup. No, so Harry Kane is your best mate. Okay.
Yeah, I should admit that. Yeah.
No, that's fine. No, that sounds great. And so, what kind of do you love about Craven Cottage? Is it the atmosphere, or do you like the ground? What brings the place to life for you?
Well, I think ever since, because it's in, we sit in the Hammersmith end, which is the livelier stand.
Yeah, it gets a bad rap.
Yeah, it does get a bad rap, but I think it's got a brilliant atmosphere, especially for those London derbies. Like last year when we had QPR at home, it was mental. It was so loud, and to be fair, the QPR fans were decent as well. So it was a great atmosphere.
Do you find when you're the crowd, when you're playing your rugby matches, that really adds, like, I don't know, another 10, 20% to the game or your level?
Absolutely, and that's what's so good about, well, being out of COVID now, because playing. So I made my debut behind closed doors. There was no one there. It didn't matter to me. But the difference. Let's say the senior boys were all saying, "Oh, I bloody hate playing behind closed doors." Obviously, I didn't have any reference point to that. But now having the fans there, and especially at the Stoop, which is usually packed out,
It
which
gets lively.
It's so lovely. It's so good
Do
there.
you find that weird? Because obviously, so when you go to Craven Cottage, obviously you're on the crowd side, but then kind of obviously playing ingrained in that atmosphere. It's probably such a contrasting feeling.
Yeah, true. It gets from the other side, I guess.
But it's, I suppose, kind of, how does it differ in terms of, as in which, what kind of, do you have rituals or pre-match rituals that kind of help you get in that game atmosphere already for the big stage?
I'll have, so in the week I'll write like a couple of things I wanna, well, show on the pitch, like 2 or 3 points, and they're not like mentally detailed. It could be as much as just I want to work really, really hard. I want to work harder than anyone else, or something like that. But not really, not ritual wise. No, I'd have usually have a bowl of pasta the night before, but other
Plain
than
pasta
that.
or
Well, it's funny because my pre-match is actually a bowl of plain pasta, and all the lads ribbed into me for it because of how boring it is.
that on the day or
I'm
the
not
night
too
before?
fast. Pardon?
Is that on the day or the night before the bowl of pasta?
Yeah, day of and the night before, both, yeah.
And which player kind of has the strangest pre-match meal or maybe ritual?
Well, so one of my guys in my year, one of my mates, Oscar Beard, he is a sucker for a highlights montage. So whether that's
A top 10 on YouTube.
yeah, something like that, or even just like clips of himself, like giving a little boost. Like, it's mental. But to be fair, his rugby knowledge is also, well, from those clips is ridiculous. So he just loves the buzz, I think.
Are you not watching highlights of yourself to get you pumped up?
Nah, I get a bit, not weird before a game, but I just I'm not really fussed. I don't like overthinking it, and like I get nervous. Everyone gets nervous, but I don't like almost feeding it. Just let it simmer.
No, brilliant. So Fulham have won 3-0 at the Cottage.
I like the transition, I mean, in between head down and then in
Yeah.
Cottage. Yeah, straight in the
Are we
Cottage.
doing another transition to the next
Yeah,
game?
exactly. Full whistle
We're
goes.
head down.
Dimitri scored two. Kenny scored a screamer. Head down, head back up, and back on the beach.
Back
And
on the beach. He loves the beach. What is it? Different beach? Because
Same beach, same spot.
Same
Same
beach,
spot.
same beach. Okay. And is there a change in kind of atmosphere or people on the beach? Or are you still tranquil?
No, I'm still quiet. It's still empty. It's
You want to get away from the chaos at the
Yeah.
cottage.
Exactly. I've been absolutely buzzing after the 3-0 win. I've got to come down somehow.
And what's happening here on the beach? Are we having lunch or just going on another walk? Cricket.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk the same route back, and
Okay.
then we're gonna go for lunch. And then we're gonna go for lunch. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm interested to hear the lunch. I am
Have you
interested.
got a specific point?
I don't actually, but like, I'm imagining a pub on the seafront that's got like a jetty, pontoon. I don't know. Yeah, with like
You've
boats
been to
going
one
here
like
and there.
this quite a few times.
Pardon?
Have you been to one like this quite a few times?
Yeah, a few times, but like again, it's there's no perfect place I have in mind, so it's just why I'm kind of making it up, I think.
No, it will create it for you. Yeah. What do you want on the menu, Finn? What would be your go-to gastro pub? If you had to pick one, what would you go
for? Oh, sorry, it's going to be like a roast or something, like a lamb roast, I think. Yeah.
Lamb roast. I love
it.
Yeah.
But yeah, but I want to have that meal with my group of eight friends. My only friends, yeah. And
loads.
Yeah.
Eight
you really need eight.
Where are these eight? Are they schoolmates, rugby mates?
So most of them are from school. It's my group from school, which we're just a bunch of weirdos and we have a lot of fun. play a few rounds of cards before food comes, have a few beers.
Yeah.
And, dig in.
Which card game do you back yourself on? Where are you winning, Finn? Where are you taking?
Well, so we have this. I don't actually know the name of the game because we've made up the name of the game.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you created a card game. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. I don't know if we've. The thing is, but I don't know if we've created it because one day we were like, I swear there's a game that goes like this. And
describe the game. Describe the game.
So you're given three cards face down.
Yeah.
You're then given three cards face up, and those go on top of those three cards down.
Yeah, I feel like I know this game.
Because we call it
cards.
Yes, yeah. There are so many different cards with like different.
Like seven lower, three C through.
Yeah, seven and lower. We play eight C through. Three means you've got to pick up the deck.
Is it shithead? Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it shithead?
Yeah.
So we call it Bingo Wings because we had no idea.
Better name. We've got that name. Yeah. We'll go with that.
Bingo Wings.
Okay, I like that. Yeah. And you said a few pints in there. What's is it a lager? Are you a Guinness man?
Yeah, I love Guinness. Probably my go-to, but like I despise, in fact, thin Guinness. Just poor Guinness. I just hate it.
Yeah, I think there's nothing worse. And me and Austin are kind of talking. What's your kind of like what's your how often do you go out? What's the drinking protocol? Obviously, you know, you probably can't go into too much detail, but what's the rough schedule as a pro rugby player?
I mean, after a win, we'll definitely have a few drinks, whether that's on the bus back home or out in Twickenham or London or Guildford after the game. But I think it's a lot looser than people think. We have a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, you hear like footballers like Declan Rice and stuff saying he's never had a beer.
Yeah. Like,
give me a break. Yeah.
What light is that?
Have you been out as a whole team? Does that occasionally happen? Or
yeah, so we've got like a social committee and they put together socials every month, and that like that, where the whole team will go out, which are always good fun.
Yeah.
Is that a future plan to get on the social committee, Harlequins?
Oh no, the pressure of social sec is mental because not everyone's ever happy. And depending on like the levels that they want to voice their opinion, it's never easy.
How many people are going out? How many's in the squad?
Like 40, 45, maybe
45.
More.
45. That's an intimidating
yeah. Yeah. It's always gotta be like a big event. Like they went to Winter Wonderland in December.
Okay.
Yeah,
stuff like that, big things.
On that December note, what's your schedule around Christmas? I'm interested to see how you spent Christmas. Do you spend it with family? Like, do you have to train the day? Because do you have the Boxing Day? Is it the
the 27th, 28th? Yeah. So that's when big game usually is. And so this season we got Christmas Day and Boxing Day off. We trained on Christmas Eve and we trained on the. So we had a walkthrough on the 27th and then we played the 20th. Well, should have played. No, we did play. Played on the 28th.
Yeah. No, that's nice. Okay. So brilliant. So we're back on the beach. We played Bingo Wings, which I love. We've had a few points. And what's going on next? Where are we going?
To, well, another beach. We're getting in a little dinghy that really is too small for all of us. So it's an added drama. It's just fun. And we're heading across. So this is where Solcombe comes to my mind. So we're heading across the estuary, the other side, a bit of a journey to a little secluded beach. And we'll park up, and waiting for us is stick cricket set, towels, everything you need for like a good session at the beach is just waiting for us.
Brilliant.
And now the cricket's really getting going. It's not just a one-on-one, brother.
It's not one-on-one anymore. It's 4v4, and it's all carnage. It's getting let loose.
It's intense. And so you said, is there any other activities you do at the beach? I mean, we could arrange a jet ski or something. Is there any particular water sport you'd love to do at the beach? Maybe you haven't done it.
Oh, yeah. Tell you what would be fun. Yeah, have you seen in Amsterdam, they've done floating rugby?
No.
Oh.
No.
Amsterdam? It's on a river city somewhere where they get like a floating pitch, but there is no... The sideline is the end of the pontoon.
Oh.
And so you dive into the water to score a try and shit, and so you get pushed out to touch it into water. That'd be hilarious. I
suppose. Yeah. We can give you that.
We're definitely getting the floating rugby pitch on. And we could get a nice 4-on-4, maybe touch contact, up to you. that sounds great.
I think that'll be so much fun. Oh, and a diving board or something. And imagine like a floating diving board, about 8 meters. That'd be quite good.
Are your other mates, are they quite big rugby guys, or are you going to show?
Yeah, so I think most of them played rugby at school and really loved it. And a few did a bit of academy stuff. And I think some of them play at uni now. But we've all played rugby. They've all played rugby once, at least, yeah.
How do you find it when, I presume most of your mates went to uni, and then like the contrast of university life versus yours, and I don't know, being in more of a job environment, how do you find that?
Yeah, it was strange. In my first 2 years, I was always like kind of a bit jealous almost, like they're having so much fun, meeting loads of new people your age and going out, and It looked unbelievable, but then it was just a kind of reality check.
Yeah.
And rugby for a living.
Yeah.
You're a bit lucky. I'm just that jealousy's kind of gone now, and
I'm sure all your friends are jealous of you for sure.
Yeah. So we've kind of hit the beach, and someone's come over. They've seen you play. You're playing floating rugby with your mates. It's going brilliant. And they've said, Finn, you can play your favourite song, your absolute favourite song in the world. You can play it while you're playing this touch rugby game. What would it be, and why?
So, Lord Connor, Ice Water, and I want him there.
We'll get him to song.
I'm there. I want him in the background, and I want him just on repeat. And it's I'll be happy.
Have you seen him before? Or
I have. I saw him in 2018, and I'm seeing him next month as well, which I'm really excited for.
Where did you see him in 2018?
NAS Festival near Bristol, and it was like a. Like I'd found Mecca. It was...
What, next month, where are you seeing him?
The Ovo Wembley Arena, I think.
We'll have a listen.
Bouncing back and forth every weekend. Smooth like the change of the season. Break up, never be a reason. You say you get your coat, I say I get it for ya. Checking all your pockets, probably the paranoia. Getting close, obvious that I adore ya. One fool's moving where history, call me Mr. Moya. Maybe you're genuine, maybe I should let you in. Maybe I should focus on myself and get to shed the skin. Or maybe not, you're half-hearted like the melanin. And living off the shit that this success can bring. They don't know the stress it brings, even though the mess I'm in. two mortgages, you even know the debt I'm in. Something, something, I can't get away with anything. Like my phone blings and I let it ring. Right now, I wrote the first verse I've written in weeks. Manage to bell at my phone, but I don't wanna speak. It's Pete, reject call, message at the beat. Select all, but then press delete. Peace. My French vanilla butter pecan, bouncing back and forth every weekend. Smooth like the change of the season. Break up, we get need a reason to. My French vanilla butter pecan, bouncing back and forth every weekend. Smooth like the change of the season. Break up, never be a reason. My French vanilla butter pecan. Bouncing back and forth every weekend. My French vanilla butter pecan. Bouncing back and forth every weekend.
Great song. Noel Corner, your favourite then?
Absolutely. Yeah, I've listened to him ever since, I think, about from 13. And yeah. It's almost part of me now. I feel I've got to love what he puts out.
Yeah, I think he'd probably be quite a good person to take on the. He seems like such a nice guy as well.
Pretty cool as well.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. He's one of the coolest people I think I've. Yeah,
I'm interested on those long bus journeys all across the UK. Are you a film guy or are you just pumping Laura Carner?
Well. They're actually really social, the bus trips.
Really?
So, like, we play loads of cards, and, like, losers buying whatever on the petrol station stop or something like that. Yeah. Just a bit more competition for the day. If if there's football on, we're watching that. And
Nice.
Do you have a DJ of, like, a teammate who is designated on the Orcs every time?
Usually it's Caden Murley in the changing room.
Yeah,
he's the house DJ. Yeah,
happy with him.
I don't think I've got a voice at the moment, but I am happy.
What's his kind of music? What does he go for?
It's kind of like, you know, party music, like clubbing music, and it's kind of fits the mood pretty properly. Gets you quite. Up and well excited,
plays the crowd well.
The
art of a good DJ, I suppose. No, that's brilliant. So we've kind of had our, you know, flowing rugby, which I love, but the cricket game as well, and it's kind of coming to that time where, you know, you can do like an afternoon activity. Me and Oz also consulted Elon Musk, and we've got this private jet that can go from England to Australia in 7 minutes. So if you want, Finn, you can leave the UK. You don't have to. It's completely up to you. Is there anything in particular you'd like to do in the afternoon, in general, after these activities?
Yeah, I'd like to play the Masters with Tiger Woods.
Yeah.
But also, I'd like you to make me really good at golf as well.
We'll get in half an hour to make you just as good as Tiger Woods.
I'm fine with Tiger Woods beating me, but as long as I'm within 10 shots, let's say.
Okay.
I'm happy.
Are you a big golf fan?
I am a golf fan, but what hinders me is that I'm just not very good.
Okay. Do you play a lot? Do you manage to find, I suppose it's quite time consuming, but do you manage to hit the course?
Yeah, I mean it's the balance of, like, is your back sore enough to play or not?
Yeah,
I do. I do try to get out as much as I can with it. But I love it.
Are you in the Masters tournament, or are you playing?
Augusta. No, I think it's this warm up round or something. It's something like that.
We could make you win it for final day.
We could do a lot of things.
Yeah, so, you can.
I'm happy to. I'm happy just to play a warm-up round with him. Just get kind of the buzz of Augusta, yeah.
Well, yeah, I think Tiger would be, like, one of the most fascinating people just to spend time with, especially on your perfect day. What would you... Are there any things you want to ask him from, you know, sportsman to sportsman or even just person to person?
I think I'd pepper him with all the classics, like...
Yeah.
Like, routine and what was it like... Winning X amount of, and have you seen all those stats on Twitter? about it was something silly, like if Rory McIlroy became world number one and was a one number one for the next something silly like 5 years or something, he would still be like 10 years off Tiger's amount of time at number one.
Really?
It's something mental like that, and yeah, all of that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I don't think, because then no one's really dominated a sport like he has for that period of time.
Is he out? Is he going to come back? Is there going to be a second comeback?
I don't think so, but again, I'm shit at golf, so I don't
I think it's
not on
something.
this day though.
Not
Not on
on this
this day.
day.
Oh yeah, and I think I'd like Charlie to be there as well, little Charlie.
Yeah, his son's really good.
Oh
I think
yes.
his next
They normally
legacy.
wear matching
Yeah,
matching kit.
and their swing
But
is.
it'd be me and Tiger matching and not Charlie.
Are you going Sunday red top?
Oh yeah,
Yeah,
it's got to
you've
be,
got to
isn't
go. I could see you in the
it?
Sunday red top with the cap.
Yeah, it's not my color red, but we'll make do.
And how are you going to approach, that really difficult hole, Augusta, where you're kind of just facing the par three, where you're literally facing completely away from the hole, and literally hit it, and the slope is ridiculous. What's Tiger saying to you there?
He's saying we're taking a 9 iron in, easy swing.
There you
Aim
go.
up the hill, it'll trickle down. And
Trickle
it
down.
goes. Yeah.
It goes straight in the hole in
Great.
one.
Yeah.
That does sound brilliant. Do you watch quite a lot of golf? Is that your like second main sport or?
I wouldn't say so, but I don't watch like if there's some like, European little golf tournament going on, I wouldn't watch it. But I love watching the majors, and I find it so exhilarating. But yeah, I'd say football's probably my second sport.
And I'm interested, like, among the kind of like rugby community, do a lot of, because I know within like cricketers, a lot of them love playing golf. Like, it's a big thing there in the rugby. Out of the rugby guys, is golf popular, or is it more of a, is that not on
I
the
th I think it's I think it's club to club, but we as a club are quite big into golf. We've got a few players who, like so Jack Stafford, a young Irish nine at Queen's. He kind of when he first came to Queen's, which must have been a similar time I came, so about 3 years ago, he ha hadn't played golf that much and whatever. Got into it because the boys were into it, and he's now playing off like three or something, and it's
Really,
the
really.
grind was is mental. Yeah.
The natural talent. That is
Are you
incredible.
not quite there
Exactly.
yet?
Finn, you'll get there. You'll get there.
I better get there. I have
You
time
got a
to get into it.
handicap?
I'd be probably guessing at like 25 or
Oh, that's
something
good.
like
That's
that.
good. That's good. Yeah, that's good.
It's better than us.
Yeah.
That sounds brilliant. So kind of we've had the day with Tiger and Charlie. What's going on next? Is it dinner time or maybe a few drinks before dinner? Do you want to change where you're at, or are you quite happy in that setting?
I'd like, yeah. So I don't want to go back to where I woke up because that was kind of like in the town. So I'm going back to the coast though, and we're having it's in the middle of nowhere. No one else is around other than us eight, and the sun's setting perfectly, looking at the ocean, and we'll have like a barbecue or something, and have a few drinks. Yeah.
Is that right? So this is the same Solcombe Beach kind of town.
No, so I mean it's not specific, but like just secluded, like coast basically.
I feel like I'm getting the impression you're more like a less city kind of, less hustle and bustle, more just out of the way, would you say?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so.
Well, I feel like if you've got your mates, it's eight mates, you kind of don't need to be anywhere
Well,
else.
there's no prize money to guess where Finn wants to buy a house.
Selfie.
Well, Sam, but Solcombe's
You're
brilliant.
advertising Selfie.
That's where I'll end up. That's where you'll find me.
Plug. No, that's the barbecue. Just there's something about where having the barbecue in that beach setting when the sun's setting. It doesn't get better. What's going on on the barbecue? Are we getting steak? Are we getting burgers? Are we getting sausages? Ooh. What's going on? What would you support for you, Finn?
Yeah, so we'll have some steaks, some sausages, because they're just a nice little filler, aren't they?
Yeah.
Classic hamburgers. I think that'd be brilliant. And there's a few greens on the side to look at, not to actually eat, just because it's a bit better. Lyle Carter cooks it all and sings as he cooks.
No, not too bad. I listened to him on Off Menu. Sounds like he's quite a good cook.
Yeah, so he said he did work with like Ottolenghi with and stuff like that, and he's opened his own cooking school for kids who have learning difficulties, and yeah, he's a mental human being. I think he's brilliant. Yeah.
What are your cooking skills like, Finn?
Basic. Nutritionally, like all there, but yeah. Basic. Yeah.
Basic. Keep it simple. No, I do love that. That is a great.
Are you having to cook for yourself every dinner, lunch? How does it work? Is there a canteen?
So at the club, they'll feed us twice when we're there, whether that's like two lunches or breakfast and lunch, depending on how the day is. That's how they'll do it. I live at home at the moment, so it's I don't have to do that much cooking, which is quite nice.
Yeah.
I'm moving out next week, and so it's going to be a whole different story then. Yeah.
Where are you moving to next week?
East Twickenham, yeah.
Okay. Closer to the Stoop.
Yeah, exactly. I'd probably like walk home after a game.
How far away are you living from training? From the
I think it's roughly 40 minutes, which is a bit of a journey, but it's such a nice area. I'm well happy with it.
No, it must be nice, the home comfort. Come from a long, hard day training. Mum's cooked something lovely. It's exactly what you need. And are you living with kind of other Harlequins players or kind of?
Yeah, I'm living with Liner.
You'll get the uni experience. You will get the uni experience to some extent.
After all, yeah. But I think it's going to be loads of fun, because we're both doing university of type, and we'll be pretty busy bunnies. So yeah.
What's the university of type? Oh wait, sorry. Yeah, not doing an online university. No.
So I'm doing the open uni, and I think he's at Surrey University because it's linked with Quinn's. Yeah.
What happens at the what do you have to do for it?
Well, so you pick. So I'm doing economics, and I think. Well, basically, you can pick what modules you do each year, and therefore how much workload you get per month. And it's quite the workload is so nice, and you can kind of take your time over it and really learn stuff. And if you're busy 1 week, you don't have to do any stuff, and it's nice.
Yeah, so it accommodates for kind of like the professional schedule, which is really good.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm. And then by like, how long does it generally take to get a degree? In terms of, like, is it 3-4 years, or is that how?
Also. Typically, when you go do it full time, it'll be 3 years, and I'm doing it in six, so I'm just doing half a year every year, and I'm not too bothered, to be honest, because I'm not even going to need a degree in 6 years, or touch wood, not need a degree in 6 years. So
Okay, Ben, say your ideal situation. What would you say? You've captained England in 10, 15 years time. What do you want to be doing after rugby? Would you want to go the Johnny Wilkinson broadcasting route or managing?
I thought about coaching, like, in the limited time I've been.
Yeah.
Professional rugby player, and I'm not sure if that's for me. I wouldn't want to be a head coach, definitely. Maybe like a specific, or maybe like a scrum coach or something, I don't know, but that's to find out if I don't enjoy that.
So far away. Yeah. I mean, that's
like, exactly. And everyone always gets on us young boys back, being like, you've got to plan for your future. And it's like, I'm kind of enjoying just starting, if I'm honest.
Enjoy the moment.
But then, like you said, broadcasting would be pretty cool, and I think pretty ideal as well. Yeah.
And is the like support community, I suppose, in the Harlequins for that aspect in terms of the transition? Is it really good? Is it really well informed?
I definitely think so. And I think, the recent boys that have gone on to other careers have really already set that up before they'd left. Mm. Like the likes of Joe Gray, he left last year and he had already set up his own sports recovery company, Maya Master, and
the plug.
free stuff, please, Grayson. And Simo, he left last year as well. He's at a property company called JLL, which is pretty mega.
Brilliant. Well, I think that rounds it up.
Yeah.
I think that's brilliant.
So we started in Solcombe.
Yeah. Solcombe, a big feature through
ended
the day.
In Solcombe.
Yeah.
I love the, you've clearly got a big attachment to sport and spending time with your mates in that familiar setting, which is lovely.
Yeah. Would you say your ideal, say you had an empty Sunday, would you just sit on the sofa, get up, Sunday sport, get out sport and just watch the footy? Would you just love watching sport, any sport?
Yeah, so I do. I watch a lot. But when the European rugby weekends come along, there's usually four games on a typical Saturday, Sunday. And I found recently that I just can't watch four in a row.
That is a lot.
It's 11 to like 9 or something. And I just get like, oh, not another one. I reckon I need 3 probably is my max.
Yeah.
Well, Finn, thank you so much for coming on. It's been a brilliant podcast. Great insight into kind of things you're doing now. And also great insight to your hobbies and things like that. So I think, yeah, the listeners.
No, really good day. Yeah, I really liked it. Fulham winning 3-0, it was really good. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on.
Cheers.
Lovely. Thank you, guys. Enjoyed it.